we call a starting line. Two of these foot soldiers are out to defend what is rightfully theirs, the crown as Steamboat Champion. The 25th Steamboat Classic is ready for battle.
We've got something real big heading right for Fury.
Distance.
4 miles of closer.
It's talking to us.
Images date back 25 years.
Steamboat Classic.
Man, we better run. We're finished.
It hasn't even started.
The 25th running of the Steamboat Classic is brought to you by Caterpillar, your local Ford dealers, and the companies that care. CEFQ, the Friends of the St. Jude Midwest affiliate, the L.R. Nelson Corporation, OSF St. Francis Medical Center, and WEK25.
Modern American Classic turns 25 today. It's the 25th running of the Steamboat Classic. Hello and welcome to the riverfront in downtown Peoria, Illinois. I'm Lee Hall. Men's and women's 4 mile races, men's and women's 15K races, along with the walk. We will focus in on the men's and women's 4 mile races. Now, Glenn Latimer is the elite athlete coordinator here at the race, and he will be offering us some insight into today's festivities. Glenn, normally when one celebrates an anniversary or a birthday, they receive the gift, but the gift will go out to the runners from the Steamboat Classic today for a course record time. That person will win $25,000.
Yeah, we've tried to dangle a pretty big carrot out there to get these guys to go after this record. In the men's, it's 17 minutes and 24 seconds, set in 1995 by Josphat Machuka from Kenya. In the women's, it's a little tougher. It's 1928, which is awesome running, and Delilah Asiago set that also in 1995. We think the women's record is tough. We think the men's record might be challenged today, even though it's a little hot and sticky.
Quite a big lure, you might say. $25,000, the normal prize money is $4,000 to the winners. Let's talk a little bit about the historical perspective. 25 years ago, 153 runners lined up just behind us here. Now there's close to 5,000. You've got Olympians from across the globe here today.
There's about 24 countries and 24 Olympians in the field. I think there are five or six people who have hold world best times for various distances. It's just an awesome field, very, very deep. And there are more people now who volunteer in the training programs than ran in the first race, and there's about 1,000 volunteers out here today involved in this major community event.
One of the original organizers likens it to watching a child grow the last 25 years. It's been quite a maturation process. Let's go now into the war room with Glenn to take a look at today's field in the men's and women's 4 mile races.
In the 25th running of the Steamboat Classic, 24 countries are represented, and there are 23 Olympians in the field. Let's meet the leading contenders. Wearing number one will be the defending champion, Khalid Kanouchi, who won the race in 1997 in 17 minutes and 42 seconds, with a blistering 1 minute 54 second last half mile. This frightens the other challengers, including number two this year, Joseph Kimani from Kenya, who won 9 major road races in the USA in 1997 and holds 2 world best times. Wearing number three will be John Brown from England, who finished second last year in his Steamboat debut, and he's a great track, cross-country and road racer. Number four is the guy who finished third at Steamboat in 1996 in a very fast 17:43. This is Johannes Mabitli from South Africa. And wearing number five is Peter Gituka from Kenya, who holds the world's best time for 8 kilometers of 22:03. He was ranked number two in the world by Runner's World last year. Also challenging are two very good Kenyans, Godfrey Kiprotich, and also Andoro Osoro, who set the world best time for 10 miles last year. A very good South African, Simon Morolong, here for the fourth time, and an unheralded but very talented Angolan Olympian, Aurelio Mitty, who should do very well. In the women's race, wearing F1 will be Colleen de Roet from South Africa, the 1997 Steamboat champion in the second fastest time in Steamboat history. She's also the Pro World Champion. This is Colleen's fifth consecutive Steamboat appearance. Wearing F2 is Harumi Hiroyama from Japan, the Japanese national record holder at 3 different distances, including a 15:07 for the 5,000 meters. This is her Steamboat debut, but she should do very well indeed, with good speed. Wearing F3 is the lady who finished 6th at Steamboat in 1997. Formerly an Olympic bronze medalist and a World Championship silver medalist, this is Elena Vyazova from the Ukraine. Wearing F5 is Nadia Prasad from France. She's had 2 fourth place finishes here at Steamboat. And wearing F6 is Lithuanian Olympian Stefania Statkuviena, who was 8th at Steamboat last year. She has good track and cross-country credentials. Once again, we have deep international fields here ready to compete in the 25th running of the Steamboat Classic.
Glenn, I want to focus in on a couple of the men that you talked about there because I think that matchup is really interesting. Khalid Kanucci and Joseph Kamani, the top 2 seeds, they ran head-to-head last year 4 different times. Kanucci, who won here a year ago, only 1-3 against Kamani last year.
Yeah, but I think it's going to be very interesting today. We have four very good Kenyans. Ondoro Soro, world record holder at 10 miles. Peter Gituka, who's world record holder at 8 kilometers. Also Godfrey Kiprotich, who's finished 4th in the world championships. And Kamani, who holds 3 or 4 different world bests. They're all going to be hammering, and they've all talked about what they're going to do to try and beat Kanucci. There are 4 South Africans who are going to run as a team in the middle of the race to try and beat. They're all scared stiff of Kanucci and his kick after seeing what he did last year. And Kanucci's just going to sit on them and try and beat them at the end. It's going to be very interesting.
Khalid had quite a lead when he broke the tape here 1 year ago. Let's take a look now at the 4-mile course with our tour guide, Neil Ninman, as we go full throttle.
Welcome to the starting line of the 1997 Steamboat Classic. Join me on a tour of the course today, a course that is the world's fastest 4-mile road race. And try to keep up with the boat.
Let's roll out the map as we head up Hamilton Boulevard and into our first turn. On to Monroe Street and into the near Northside neighborhoods.
As we pass through the Northside neighborhoods, we're approaching the 1-mile mark. So we just got to keep in mind that we've got 3 more miles to go.
Nearing the park, watch the lead pack start to pull away.
We've entered Glen Oak Park and approached the Ingersoll statue at the 2-mile turnaround. Many of the runners at this point will jockey for position to make that strong finish the final 2 miles down to the finish line.
Stay with me as we race back towards downtown. Just past the 5K mark, we have less than 1 mile to go. Runners race through the Spalding Mall. Runners will be at full throttle as they make the turn onto Hamilton. It's all downhill from here.
Well, we've made it close to the finish. Right now we're down Hamilton Hill, the fastest part of the race course, heading into our last turn.
Pick it in and sprint to the finish.
We made it. I hope you're able to keep up with the boat on our course tour today. You know, that really is the fastest 4-mile road race. Lee, back to you.
All right, Neil, thanks very much. Somebody's number is up today. Will it be one of these guys? We'll find out. Don't go away. Welcome back to the riverfront in downtown Peoria, the 25th running of the Steamboat Classic. We want to throw it now to our own Scott Eunice, who is with race director Phil Lockwood.
Thanks, Lee. Phil, what are your feelings before this 25th running?
Well, it's a special event for the Illinois Valley Striders where the pressure is on to put on a great show. All of our peers are here from the Roadrunners Club of America convention. With it being our 25th anniversary, we've done a lot of special things all year, but I think this is the focal point for everyone.
How's it gone so far this year?
Well, we were operating at the pace of May by January, and it's picked up since there, so sort of breakneck speed. It's a wonder we're all still together, but we're doing well, and we're going to have a great race.
Thanks, Phil. All right, back to you, Lee.
Phil took over for a long time race director Steve Sjostrom in the second decade of this race, and he will be taking the race into the next millennium. This race started as a mom and pop organization, 153 runners back in 1974 lined up just behind me here. They had to get special permission from the city of Peoria to run in the street. The city originally had them running on the sidewalks. They've come a long way, baby, if we can borrow a line. Now it's an Olympic caliber event. Olympians from all across the globe come to Peoria for the best little road race in America.
And up on the Illinois River, that's the very best time of the year. Those steamboat days in August, like a hazy, lazy dream. I want to be at the foot of Main Street when the Julie Bell raises steam. When the Julie Bell raises steam.
Humble beginnings for the best little road race in America. In August of 1974, Nixon was on his way out and the Steamboat Classic was in. 153 runners lined up on Hamilton Boulevard for that first race, Levi cutoffs and all.
We started out when we had 153 people in the race. We thought that there's no way we could top that.
The finish line, we had somewhat of a similar oil cloth that we painted Steamboat finish line and put it up between two volleyball standards that were held upright by large tires filled with concrete. It's been quite a race and quite a growth, and I remember back, you know, Steve had called me at 3 just so I would get up and we'd take a van that was probably in the 1960 vintage, and we would begin it down at downtown on what's now Constitution Avenue or Steamboat Avenue, and we would take off up to the park putting out the cones.
The foot traffic has gone up considerably since then. Almost 5,000 runners will start the 25th Steamboat Classic. The growth among citizen runners was constant and steady the first 10 years of the race. Its popularity among Olympic caliber athletes took a leap forward in 1986. Prize money was added with the help of former Peoria Mayor Jim Maloof.
They needed money and asked me for some leads on how, you know, who some of the major givers were in Peoria and so forth. At that time, Famous Bar, a department store, was coming to Peoria and they'd asked me to do a little something for them. And I kind of used that as my intro to saying, well, I'll do this if you'll consider being a major sponsor for one of the real great events that is happening in Peoria. And they said, yeah, we'll do it. I just came along at the right time and put a little window dressing on it.
And the athletes followed. With that kind of bait, elite athlete coordinator Glenn Latimer started reeling world-class runners into Peoria right away, starting with Arturo Berrios. All he did was break the course record by 46 seconds, running a world record 17 minutes, 34 seconds.
I started using some of my contacts and people I'd met in the running business, and so I got my friends to come to the race. So it was just really interesting, and it's just been all uphill since then.
A new women's world record came in 1990. Canada's Sue Lee ran 20:10 to better Francie LaRue Smith's mark. In 1994, a wrong turn by Kenya's Lameck Aguda didn't cost him the title. 3 years later, Aguda won the Boston Marathon. In 1995, another men's record. Kenya's Josphat Machuca, 10 seconds better than Barrios, running 17:24. That record still stands. 5 years later, Lee's record fell. Kenya's Delilah Asiago smashes the record by 42 seconds, running in 19 minutes and 28 seconds. The parade of Olympians into Peoria is in its second decade now, and the best little road race in America is moving into its second quarter century.
Thinking back to it, is it almost like having a child and watching the child be born, and by the time they're 25, you've gone through a lot of things, and but yet, you know, you've watched this mature, and you've watched the thing continue to grow and become better every year, and it's kind of like next year will be better than this year, and the year after that will be better than next year. So every year it gets better, but it's kind of neat. I guess we're kind of special for us is the fact that we can look back to the beginning and the infancy of the whole thing.
I think maybe what we've done is we've outworked the people that put on other races. You know, you go to some of these places and they got a new race director every year. Well, that person's starting from scratch. And this race has had the continuity because it's been Steve Shostrom. You know, granted, he gets accolades, people pat him on the back, but also he's been the guy that he answers the bottom line question. And he takes a lot of responsibility. He's taken a lot of heat. And he stuck with it.
Nurturing friendships, I think, is what I would remember. There are so many people that I still know and still love that were there the first year. They're still around. So much has evolved in all of our lives over 25 years, but the race and the feeling that the people have for the event seems to be a constant.
It's been quite a ride, and we look forward to the next 25 years. We go now to Scott Eunice, who is with the original race director, Steve Shostrom, the guy that got it all started. Scott?
Thanks, Lee. Steve, this race has been your baby from the beginning, 25 years. Talk about how it's grown.
My kids always said that the Steamboat was the favorite kid of the family. And it's been very gratifying to see all this develop over the years. And now I get to run in it. It doesn't get any better than that. It'd be real great.
When you're standing out there in front of all the runners here in just about 15 minutes, what's going to be going through your mind?
It's just the usual stuff. I have to admit that I worry about the logistics of the race, and I was worrying about some things that were going on. And then I thought to myself, well, I better get ready to run because that's what I'm supposed to do this morning. So then I put my shoes on, and just like all the other runners, I decided I better get out there and do it.
Thanks, Steve. Congratulations. Good luck. Lee, back to you.
All right, Scott, thank you very much. You can see the people gathering here for the start of the race, and it's all a testament to Steve Sjostrom and his friends who got it all started back in 1974. It's a little bit humid this morning, but a course record will be rewarded with $25,000. We'll be around to see if that is handed out today here at the Steamboat Classic. We'll be back with more from the riverfront in Peoria in just a minute. We're just moments away from the start of the 25th annual Steamboat Classic. Let's throw it back to our own Scott Yunus.
Thanks, Lee. Mel Schrieffer running the race for the 25th year today. How you feeling?
Well, I feel good. I'm kind of elated about running this for the 25th time. My speeds are much slower now than they were 25 years ago, but the idea now is just to get through it, not worry about the speed.
25th Steamboat Classic for Mel Schrieffer. Back to Lee and Glenn.
All right, Scott, thank you very much. Mel Schrieffer Jr., Jerry Kokish, Bev Enslow, the three runners who've run every Steamboat Classic, and another good crowd on hand this morning, Glenn.
Yeah, and there's F8, Solange Cordeiro, all the way from Brazil, Mohamed Baket from Palestine, just getting loose, warming up. Stefania Stakuven giving us a smile, number F6. And our defending champion, just getting prepared there, is number one. That's Kelly Kanucci from Morocco. We'll see what he can do today.
It's really amazing, Glenn, to think that it was a handful of folks in cutoff jeans 25 years ago, and then to see the talent that's here today from the elite racing world.
Nice wave there from Japanese champion Harumi Hirayama, some of our South African runners, and the women's defending champion, F1. That's Colleen DeRuyck from South Africa talking with Nadia Prasad.
Colleen's looking very fit this year.
Number five, there's Peter Gathuka, the world record holder in the 8K. And there's Elena Viazza, Olympic bronze medalist. And the guy who won the race in 1986 in a world record, Arturo Barrios.
The man that got it all started in the money-winning era back in 1986, a world record time of 17:34 in this race. I don't think he'll come very close to that today. They're just about ready to get started on Hamilton Boulevard. That's the one thing that hasn't changed over the last 25 years. They will start on Hamilton Boulevard in Peoria and finish it up down along the riverfront. They're off and coming up Hamilton Boulevard from high above downtown Peoria. This is always an amazing shot to see the flock of people coming up the hill.
There's a whole street full of them there now, and they look very, very good as they start out. The pace will be pretty quick. We expect the lead runners to be running at least 4:20 per mile pace, and then all the way back to people running 10, 11, 12, 13 minutes per mile. So the street will be full very quickly here.
And that's where organizers say they will grow in when it comes to this race, is right there, the citizen runners who make up bulk of this 25th annual Steamboat Classic, getting some support from the crowd there. And there's our lead pack as they head up Hamilton Boulevard and get ready to turn onto Monroe.
And you can see there that the Kenyan runners and the South African runners are already trying to implement their plan, which is to try and take the kick out of Kelly Kanucci. So pushing the pace there, number 10, Godfrey Kiprotich from Kenya. Colleen DeRuyck seems to be leading in the women's race, got clear already.
Make a tight turn around there, and as we move on to Monroe, we have an early leader who's got a lot of company.
Yeah, the number 16 is Charles Malinga, who's had two top 10 finishes in the last 2 years. On the far left is Ondoro Osoro from Kenya. We're in eight, and he was the world set a world best last year at 10 miles. And then over on the far right is very smooth, wearing number two, is Joseph Kimani from Kenya.
Here we go back to the ladies, and Colleen DeRourke has already opened up a lead in the women's race. She looks very fit this year, Glenn.
She looks so fit and so smooth. Colleen is the consummate road racer. She just looks so smooth. The men's runners there passed the first mile in 4:22. Still Malinga, number 16, pushing the pace with Kiprotich, number 10, and number 8, Osoro.
How many gentlemen in this pack do you think would have a chance at winning this today?
Probably 3 or 4 have a chance of winning it. There's 8 or 10 who can influence the race. Tucked way back in the middle is Kelly Kanucci, the champion. Back to Colleen DeRourke.
Colleen with the early lead. The Roadrunners Club of America has picked Peoria as their convention site, and we talked to their leader and asked him, why come to Peoria?
We like the beer here. No, it's a wonderful race. We have a couple of really good running clubs here, and when our members travel to other cities, they like to go places where there are well-established races like Steamboat.
State representatives and delegates from running clubs around the country enjoying the expo, which is part of the convention.
We'll be back with mile 2 of the Steamboat Classic coming up next. Welcome back to Peoria, Illinois, the 25th running of the Steamboat Classic. Glenn Latimer and Lee Hall. And Glenn, there is still a pretty impressive pack there heading down Monroe.
Yes, and pushing the pace on the far left of the picture is Ondoro Osoro wearing number 8. You can see here on the map exactly where the runners are in the second mile as they move forward. Here's Colleen DeRourke pushing away easily in the women's race, not being challenged at all, Lee.
She is trying for her second straight Steamboat Classic title, as is Colleen Kanucci. There you can see, we can't see a lady behind Colleen. She's opened up such a large lead. There's Joseph Kamani with the early lead.
Yes, he looks very smooth and looks very good indeed. The Kenyans take it in turn to push the pace.
Joseph Kamani leading a deep men's field, one that has the respect of the 1997 champ.
Yeah, this year, absolutely. This year, the competition is more intense, and The race has tough field this year. We have too many Kenyans, South Africans, and the race is going to be tough this year.
And Khalid is perfectly correct, because the Kenyans are pushing the pace here. Joseph Kamani, number 2, is pushing ahead of his countryman Peter Gatuka, then Godfrey Kiprotich, the third Kenyan, and Kanuchi's tucked in their third, fourth place at the moment with 3 South Africans right behind him. So the pace is pretty tough.
We're not used to seeing people pull for each other, I don't think, in individual sports. Does that really go on?
Yes, I think that there's been a plan. The South Africans have talked together, so have the Kenyans. They're frightened of what Kanucci can do at the end of the race.
Colleen DeRourke doesn't look like she needs much help as she gets closer to Glen Oak Park. Number 1 in the world as a road racer last year by both Runner's World and Running Times, and she is looking so strong today.
She looks wonderful today. She is the premier road racer. Kanucci there, tucked in 3rd place, right behind Kamani and Gatuka. Kamani's velvety smooth, Kanucci has a sort of rolling action.
Kamani going for the championship. Now let's check in with 1990 women's champ, Sue Lee.
I just don't get to go to big races anymore, and this is like my roots. And there's nowhere I'd rather go than Peoria, so I'm just so happy to be here and outrunning about 7 or 8 minute miles, and it's still pretty hard, which is scary. But I have a lot of respect for what the top runners are doing and what everybody's doing out there. It's a wonderful race.
Sue Lee set the world record 20 minutes 10 seconds back in 1990, and she's just a great lady all around, Glenn.
Oh, I adore Sue Lee. She can come back when she's 75 years old. She'll always be a guest at Steamboat. She's great.
Let's go back to the men now.
Okay, number 2 is Joseph Kamani. Just behind him is his teammate Peter Gatuka. Then number 1 is our defending champion Kali Kanucci, and on the far right, that's Johannes Mabitli from South Africa.
Back to Colleen DeRourke. She is all alone except for a male counterpart there, but there's no ladies in sight.
No, Colleen's really just blown this field away. There's nobody even in the picture frame, so we don't even know how close they are at this time.
This is Colleen's 5th consecutive Steamboat Classic as we go back to the men and they get closer to Glen Oak Park.
And on to Abingdon, ready to make the turn into the park. Peter Gatuka, number 5, leads. Number 2, that's Joseph Kamani, former Beatley. 1 is, that's Kanucci, our champion.
Kanucci making a move. Is it down to these 4 guys now, Glenn?
I would say the leaders coming out of these top four or five, that Simon Morrelung's trying to rejoin that group as they go into Glen Oak Park, and they're going to go by the new Michael Sonnemaker statue, which was unveiled earlier this week. And Mabitli trying to push here, and there's a good reason for this, because the first runner past the two-mile mark gets a bonus of $500. So Mabitli's interested in this bonus, as you can tell. He's pushing the pace. Gathuka's also got interest in this bonus. So they're round the corner, and then they've got about 80 yards down to the two-mile marker. Gathuka leads it. Looks like he's got the... Oh, no, he doesn't. Here comes Mabitli and sprinting past. $500 is $500, Lee.
He's a great story. He didn't start running until he was 22 years old after a soccer career. He worked in a gold mine as an electrician. And he powers up right there.
That looks like the end of the Olympic 100-meter final.
Colleen DeRurk looking strong on the women's side. We talked to her before the race about how she got ready to defend her title.
I haven't done many road races. I was training for the Boston Marathon, so I don't do too many road races. And then I took a break and I ran Boulder and I came second. So this race is the first race that I'm sort of getting back into the role of things.
Colleen DeRurk, a very strong marathon runner when you look at her record over the years.
Oh, she's got a great record. Here are the men now. They're just back on Abingdon getting ready to turn onto Madison for the return to Peoria, down to the city center. Kamani leads, followed by Kanucci. Number one versus number two. This is the duel we waited for, Lee. And right behind them, Peter Gathuka. You've got some three very talented individuals there, and these are the three that appear to be breaking away.
And now let's check in with another Steamboat Classic. 86 champ and former world record holder Arturo Berrios.
This is a great feeling just to see the people that, you know, when I was running back in 86, a lot of people are back, people are happy. We're not running that fast anymore, but we're still running. So it's just great to see people, you know, they were running back in the 1980s. Now there are new people coming in, you know, younger people running faster, which is always good to see. But it's just, you know, having just a great time and happy to be back in Peoria.
And back to the ladies' race. Colleen DeRurk trying to defend her championship from a year ago, and she is way out in front on the ladies' side.
There's Harumi Hirayama in second place. She's making the turn there in Glen Oak Park, but some distance already behind Colleen DeRurk. Back on Madison, here are the men's runners. Peter Gathuka pushing on the inside with Kamani, and then suddenly Khalid Kanucci tried to drop in behind Gathuka.
Anybody there look like they have an advantage yet?
No, it's just Gathuka still trying to push the pace. Obviously, they're still trying to get away from Kanucci.
It's a three-man race as they approach the three-mile point in the 25th running of the Steamboat Classic.
Bit of a move here by Gathuka, Lee, and he's trying to push the pace, and it looks like Kanucci's having to work hard to stay with him. Meanwhile, back in Glen Oak Park, we can see the new statue of former IBS club member Michael Sonnemaker. This statue was produced by Joy Kessler in bronze.
And there's Colleen DeRurk all alone in the women's race, the 25th running of the Steamboat Classic. Welcome back, Lee Hall, along with Glenn Latimer. And Glenn, she's having a great race today, and she talked about her training a little bit earlier. She's having a great year, too. What she didn't mention was the world record she set earlier this year.
Yes, I saw a race in Washington, D.C. back in April, and she ran 51.16 for 10 miles, which is a new world record in very difficult conditions, and she's just a powerhouse as a racer.
We saw where Colleen was on Madison. Now let's fast forward ahead to the men.
Some interesting developments here, Lee. You can see that number two, Joseph Kamani's dropped off about 5 yards, which doesn't seem like too much, but it is at this stage of the race. And the reason for that is the surge that's going on from number five, Peter Gathuka, who's pushing the pace, trying to get away. Kanucci's hanging with it. Gathuka's got good credentials. He's run 22.03, which is the world best time for 8 kilometers, slightly more than this distance, but it's nearly 5 miles. So this guy is good, got good credentials, and Kanucci and Gathuka are away from Kamani at this stage.
And back to Colleen DeRurk. One question I wanted to ask you, are you surprised to see a marathon runner like Colleen do so well at this distance?
Not really, because Colleen's got the complete package. She can run cross-country, she can run track, she can run roads. She's just a powerhouse.
Colleen DeRurk, as we mentioned earlier, this is her fifth consecutive Steamboat Classic. And there you get a look at the head-to-head battle now between Khalid Kanucci and Peter Gathuka. And we talked earlier about how Kanucci set up against Kamani and how Kamani was 3-1 against Kanucci last year. These two have gone head-to-head in the past, too, and Kanucci has won both times. He is 2-0 against Peter Gathuka head-to-head.
And it will be interesting to see what happens here. Obviously, Kamani is now out of the race. That 5 yards that seemed not so significant has suddenly become 30 yards, and now it's the winner will come from one of these two. Gathuka on the left, Kanucci on the right. Gathuka being the aggressor here, he's trying to take that sting out of Kanucci. He doesn't want to be around him with the last half mile because they've all seen the video from last year. They know what Kanucci can do at the end.
Yeah, a minute 54 in the last half mile, so they know he has an outstanding kick. It doesn't look like Colleen's going to need a kick today.
No, she's cruising away comfortably, not even bothering to take drinks here. She's just floating along.
You might remember last year she was down to the wire, really, with Lorna Kiplagat. They had that fantastic finish in the last half mile, and we're not going to see that in the women's race today.
No, she's clear, and she's not running quite as quickly as last year, but these guys are moving right along here, and you can see now that Kanucci's checked that Kamani's dropped back, and he's just concentrating now on Peter Gathuka, and he's come alongside him. Gathuka's made his effort, and then he's pushing again, so this battle is going backwards and forwards by these guys.
You mentioned that Gathuka is the world record holder at 8K. Oddly enough, Kanucci beat him at 8K earlier this year at the Shamrock 8K.
Yeah, they just passed 3 miles there in 13:11. So if they're going to get after this world record, that means they've got to run very, very fast for the last mile, 4:13 or better, which is moving right along. It's not impossible, but we'll see whether the racing with them gets them close to the world record that they need.
Peter Gathuka and Khalid Kanucci running for the win, and Colleen DeRurk seems to have it all sewn up. As you look at her past Steamboat appearances, her first visit here was in 94. She finished 7th. And then you look at her times and how she did. She ran faster the next year by 38 seconds, finished 9th. She improved by 22 seconds and moved up to 3rd. And then last year, her 19:55 finish, which was the second fastest women's time in Steamboat history, Glenn.
She's got a great record here. She's very proud of coming to Steamboat for the 5th time. Her husband, Darren, brags that he's been here one more time than her, and he makes a point of mentioning that whenever possible.
It's nice to see quality people and quality athletes like Colleen coming back year after year, and it's still a two-man race on the men's side.
And what is interesting now is the aggressor has suddenly become number one, Kanucci. You saw Gathuka pushing, but just by about a yard there, that's Kanucci who's starting to push, trying to put the pressure onto Gathuka. Gathuka matching him, but the race is on now. Back to Colleen.
Colleen's checking her watch to see if she still has a shot at a world record, and she's probably hurt by the fact that it's not really much of a race.
Well, there's not much of a race in terms of not being challenged, but more importantly, the record is phenomenally good. It's 19 minutes and 28 seconds by Delilah Asiago from 1995, and it's a very, very good record indeed.
And former world record holder Arturo Berrios explains one steamboat tradition.
There was a storm, and it was raining so hard that the lights went out, and people were basically waiting and waiting, and then I just came with the idea of making an airplane. People thought that I was crazy, and then all of a sudden we had about 100 planes just flying all over the place.
Yeah, I'm glad we got that all cleared up. Coming up next, the steamboat finish. And we're back at the 25th Steamboat Classic. There's a look at the finish line. The folks eagerly awaiting the runners. Over 1,000 volunteers helped set things up with this race, including the setup at the finish line.
Finish line setup has changed quite a bit over the years due to all the equipment that Aggregate Equipment brings to us. We're able to do a lot more and do it a lot faster. We used to work until pretty late in the night on Friday night. Now we're done pretty late in the afternoon, and we got this down pretty much to a science. We'll have at it, and we'll be ready.
The unsung heroes of the Steamboat Classic. And this is what they wait for, the final mile. Khalid Kanucci and Peter Gathuka as they come through the Spalding Mall, my alma mater, I might add. It's a two-man race, Glenn.
Yes, and look what's happening, Lee. It's Khalid Kanucci who's pushing the pace, and Gathuka's working hard to hang on. And this is exactly the place where Kanucci exploded last year and broke away from everybody, and he's doing exactly the same thing. And away he goes again. He just pushes with half a mile to go. And what was 2 or 3 meters as they came out of Spalding Mall is suddenly 10 meters. And he's heading now for the corner back onto Hamilton Boulevard. And it's very, very hard for anybody to catch him once he gets onto Hamilton because it's sloping downhill gently towards the river. It's Cannucci who makes the turn first. And that 2 or 3 meters has become 20 meters. And in third place, Joseph Kamani. Cannucci is away.
He is away, all right. Peter Gutuca is out of it. Now the question becomes, does Cannucci have enough left to go for that world record?
As he approaches the quarter mile to go mark, the question is really, can he do it? Because he's got to run 55 seconds for this last quarter mile, and that's really asking something after the battle he's had with Gutuca up to this point. He's striding away very strongly. Looks good now as he comes down Hamilton, about to cross Washington Street.
Khalid Cannucci, the fastest marathon debut in history at Chicago last fall in 2 hours, 7 minutes, and 10 seconds. He won at Steamboat a year ago, and now he's going for the world record. He's still got a shot at it. It's going to be close.
He did a little check there behind him just to make sure he was safe, and so he comes now to the final corner, the most exciting part. Another little check over his shoulder just to make sure he's clear, and another check. Round the last corner, and it's 100 meters to the finish, and Cannucci is sprinting now. He's going to be just outside, Lee. He's not going to break 17:24. Yep. Clock's ticking now, 17:28, 29:30. Another great victory there for Cannucci ahead of Peter Guthuka in second place, Kimani third, and Mitty fourth.
And now back to the ladies, Colleen DeRourcq. Doesn't look like she's going to have a world record either, Glenn. It looks like they're going to save you 25 grand today.
Yes, and coming from behind there, number 36 is he's come from some way behind, is her husband, Darren DeRourcq, and he's obviously got a little ego invested here. He's trying to break away from his wife towards the finish with half a mile to go.
Is it legal to draft?
Well,
when your husband's in front of you?
I think that's an interesting question. I don't think he was anywhere near her, so I don't think there's any question of pacing her. He's just come running from behind, and now he's obviously doesn't want to be beaten by his wife in this race, so he's getting away as quickly as he can.
I think one other thing we need to talk about, Glenn, the humidity and just how thick it is here. It would be an awful lot to ask of anybody to run world record time today.
The fact that the humidity is up there at 89% is making the difference. The temperature is 70, 71 degrees, but it's that humidity factor. So if 10 degrees less humidity, these guys would be running so much faster. Colleen would be going 10 seconds plus faster, and so would Khalid Cannucci, and 10 seconds faster would have gotten him a world best, so we probably saved ourselves $25,000 thanks to the humidity, but actually we'd have preferred to give that money out. Colleen now crosses Washington, and she's got less than a quarter mile now to the finish.
This will be the first time in her Steamboat history that she has not run faster than she did the year before.
But she is doing very well in her fifth appearance here and to defend the titles, and we're going to have double repeat champions here, both in the men's and women's races, because Colleen's going to defend her championship. And we're setting up a pretty interesting race in 1999 for a three-peat by both Khalid Cannucci and by Colleen DeRourcq. So Colleen strides away now, just over 20 minutes, and she's going to win comfortably, some distance ahead of her nearest challenger. Colleen DeRourcq is the champion today. In second place is Harumi Hirayama from Japan, and finishing third is Stefania Statkuven from Lithuania. Khalid Cannucci defends his championship in 1730. Second is Peter Guthuka in 1736, and third Joseph Kamani in 1740. In the women's race, Colleen DeRourcq wins in 2012 ahead of Harumi Hirayama in 2052, and in third place Stefania Statkuven in 2112. We'll be right back. Steady stream of runners now coming to the finish line, being applauded as they finish, including Ed McGraw, one of the race founders, getting congratulations as he reaches the finish line. And Ed's looking for a Bud Light, I think, there on the floor. Now let's join Lee Hall with our winner, Khalid Cannucci.
And here he is, the first man to defend his title in the money-winning era at Steamboat. Khalid, congratulations on a great race. You were about, 14 seconds faster than last year?
Yeah, I ran this year a little faster because of the tough field this year. Steamboat really has a tough field, formed by many Kenyans athletes and South Africans and professionals, and I'm so glad to come back here and to defend my title.
Faster this year, but no world record. Tell me about it. You were you had a chance at it.
Yeah, but I wasn't thinking in any moment to go for world record. Most important today to win against tough guys to give me more confidence for pitch three road race.
Tell me about the pack at about the 2 mile point. There was like everybody was kind of helping each other out, and you guys were on world record pace at the 2 mile and still had the shot at it coming down the stretch.
It's like I said, we were in pace of world record and 2 mile mark. I was feeling a little bit tired because of the humidity, but after we passed the 2 mile mark, I start getting better. I start getting more confidence, and that by 3 mile mark, I knew that I'm gonna win. I'm gonna defend my title this year.
Yeah, I know before the race you talked about defending it. How much does it mean to you to come back here and race against this kind of quality competition and defend your title?
It means a lot to me. It means a lot to come back here to Steamboat to this special race and defend your title, and especially this year. This year is a tune-up for the pro circuit final that is going to be in Peachtree, so I have more confidence now.
All right, congratulations, Khalid Kanucci.
Thank you very much.
On Wednesday evening, we held the junior steamboat races for children ages 3 through 11, and the elite athletes jogged alongside some of these little kids. And now let's go and join Lee Hall with our women's leader, Colleen DeRook.
And the women's winner defended her title as well, Colleen DeRook. Congratulations. Not quite as fast as last year.
No, I was hoping to go under 20 minutes again this year. I think I'm fitter this year. I've done more training since my Boston Marathon than I did last year, so I thought I was fitter and I thought I could easily do it. But it didn't come today.
Yeah, yeah, it was a little thick out there, very humid. Was that any concern for you?
Not concerned. I don't mind running the humidity. When I started warming up this morning, I've walked out of time and I thought, oh, it's not too humid. But once we'd warmed up and that, I could feel it was more humid. And last year, I don't think it was as humid as this year. So I think that does play a small role in times. I thought, you know, there would be Harumi and Nadia would be with us the whole way, and we would be like working hard together. But I think I started a bit too fast. And so I didn't see them, so I was running on my own.
Tell me what it means to you to come here and defend your title.
It's great because, you know, I tried for many years just to win Steamboat, and then I won last year, and I was very happy. And then to come back and defend it again this year, it was good.
Among the racers today, 78-year-old Warren Utis and F40 Kim Jones, running with her daughter Jamie and her friend Teresa. And let's join race founder Steve Shostrom talking about the event.
Actually, when Dave Snyder and Ed McGraw and I pledged that we would run it in 25 years, I think it'll stay on. I think it's an institution now, and I think it'll carry on. Whether I'll be here in 25 years is another matter, but if I'm alive and kicking, I will be there.
The 15K races run simultaneously with the 4 mile race, and winning today were John Weigel, here wearing number 6. He's from Metamora, and also Angie Zimmerman, now at Bradley University.
Almost a world record today, about 4 seconds or so off. Another great race run by Khalid Kanucci, who really improved on his time from a year ago.
He ran very well indeed, and he became the aggressor with about 3/4 of a mile to go. It was very interesting to watch him race. He was very determined. The Kenyans tried to gang up on him, the South Africans tried to gang up on him. He was still tough, and he hung tough. It was a wonderful run by him.
Are you surprised with the depth of that field and to see a repeat winner in this day and age? Since the money's come along, that's never happened, and it happened both in the men's and the women's?
In the men's race, it was a very, very stacked field. So what was interesting was that I talked to Kelly Kanucci last October, and he promised me, A, that he wouldn't race too much this year, because I was giving some advice about his career so that he can have a nice, long, and very successful career. He said, I will be fit for Steamboat. I will be ready for Steamboat. I'll be ready then for the Peachtree Road Race and then Chicago Marathon. He says, don't worry what I'm doing early in the year. And I looked him in the eyes, and I believed him. He's a good young man.
All right, great. Another fantastic effort. 25 years and going strong.
Yeah, and I'm looking forward to still standing here with you 25 years from now.
Well, let's hope. Congratulations on another job well done. Thank you for your help. And that'll do it from the riverfront, a great anniversary race, the 25th running of the Steamboat Classic. For more information on the Steamboat Classic, join us at our website at week.com.
That party's good.